Hello YouTube, it's Krosama. And here I'm just gonna give a really quick review on these effect parts. This is the Effect Rocks beige version. So let's just go ahead and take a look at the box first. When I first seen this, I was like, oh, it looks kind of interesting. And when I looked at these rocks, I was kind of thinking more of asteroids. So like, oh, maybe I can go ahead and put them on some stands and kind of make them hover around the models when I do my review. But you're gonna pretty much soon realize that you can do it, but you're gonna have to do some like tinkering. But here, very very basic cover art, and all that's gonna be right here is just gonna be these actual rocks that you can see with the clear plastic underneath. Underneath, nothing really crazy on this side, nothing crazy, blank and blank. So taking a look at the back, the instruction manual is actually printed on the back. So there's not really much to really instruct you on. It just kind of tells you like, hey, all these little tiny rocks can be joined together, which I'll go ahead and I'll show you. But they have like all these little connection points all over the rock. So you can go ahead and make like one big, one big rock. Or you can go ahead and just make a whole bunch of little tiny ones, or however you want to do it. And it kind of gives you some little examples right over here, which is pretty awesome. I mean, this would be good for Dragon Ball, SH Figure Arts. Yeah. Or even the standard Figure Eyes. This would be good for that. And that's kind of like what I'm thinking about. Maybe I can go ahead and get all my DBZ figures and I can put these rocks around them. I can get those little special effect parts and everything. But I was really hoping that this can be more for the asteroids. But you can see some different little pictures. So splitting a rock in half, kind of like walking around, and then you got one hiding behind a bunch of boulders. So, I mean, I would think this is like really cool stuff to put in like a diorama or scenery or whatever. I personally think they actually look pretty cool. But let's go ahead and take a look at each of the rocks. Okay, so first up, you're gonna have like these big rocks right here. These are like the bigger parts of them. So they are extremely detailed. Like, I love the color. I love like the little shading and everything. It looks really good. And then you're gonna have these obvious holes pretty much scattered all throughout it. And to my knowledge, they're all the same exact size, which, I mean, yeah, it's cool and all, but I was really hoping that you would have some smaller size ones, because this is the thing. I have a bunch of these stands, right? I have a whole bunch of axe stands. They can't fit. They are, they're non-compatible. Even like some of these Figma stands, none of these can fit as well. I might have some pegs somewhere around here that can actually plug into this, but so far this cannot. However, what you can do is you could take the stand off of the actual, the base of the stand, and you can plug this into here. So if you want it, you can lay this flat, and then you can essentially start plugging in stuff like so. Okay, and here is like one instance where you can go ahead and utilize the stand with the rock. So, I mean, it's not bad. I would scatter them across like all over the ground, obviously. But just to give you a quick demonstration, this is kind of like how it's going to look. Now you can just plug in all the little rocks all over. And then if you want, you could take these little parts off. I've already kind of put them all over. But you could take these off and then plug in more stands like right here on the side if you really want. It's just really up to you. So if you want, you can get like a whole bunch of kits scattered throughout this kind of area and, you know, make yourself a little terrain. So especially if you want to play any kind of like, I don't know, if you, like tabletop games or something like that, these can really be used to enhance that kind of gameplay. Okay, you're going to get a bunch of these little pegs right here. All you're going to do is plug these into the same socket like you would with the smaller boulders. And then with that, you're just going to plug in the other compatible boulders right inside. And that's pretty much about it. Now you can also, like, if you're having trouble trying to take these out, it gives you a tool right here. So you can kind of like just pry it right out. There you go. So you just pretty much put it like that, and bam, now you can go ahead and pull out the pegs if it just becomes stuck or something like that. And then one of the biggest things you really want to do is experiment. So just kind of like see what the weights are for these things. Some of them are relatively heavy, but if you get it in the right angle and you have a really solid kit, generally you can go ahead and, you know, pull off some decent looking poses. So like right here, I got my Titus holding up the boulder, because I would think he would kind of like, you know, host it on his shoulder and then getting ready to throw it, and you know, probably using his other fist to break them apart, and then just throw the boulders. That's kind of like what I was thinking, especially if I was using the Titus in a kind of terrain like this. I would just be using those boulders to my advantage, since the Titus doesn't really have any kind of long distance projectiles. Okay, and here is one more pose for y'all. So it's essentially the Red Framer Stray cutting the boulder in half with his, I think this is the Gabera Strait, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, I mean, like I said, you can pull off some pretty neat stuff with this, but you're really gonna have to be imaginative and, you know, just kind of like play with it. If you can get these in the air, then you can definitely get, you know, make some little asteroids with them. Well, guys, I really don't have too much to say about these things. If you really want these in your collection, you know exactly what you can do with them, like different poses or kind of enhancing your dioramas or whatever, I think it's worth it at that point. But if you're buying them just to have the novelty of having some plastic rocks in your collection, I would probably say you can make them yourself. I don't really see these as too hard of a thing to make, you know. Just make the mold and then paint it, shade it, add the weathering effects, and I'm pretty sure you'd be good. I haven't made a boulder myself, but this is just kind of like a simple thing I wanted to buy and potentially enhance my reviews when I do actually make these videos. So I think for me it's gonna be worth it. But I can't really say the same for everyone, especially since I haven't seen a lot of people have these in their collection, unless I'm just not looking in the right places. But they're a cool little novelty. If you want to pick them up, cool. I am interested in the other effect parts. I've seen like lightning, and I've seen a couple other ones. I have another one, which is more of like the ground breaking. I haven't actually reviewed it. I haven't really done much with it, to be honest. I think I posed it with one kit. But overall, that's about it, guys. I'm going to look for some more effects so that way I can go ahead and review them. Of course, if y'all want to see these reviews. But that's it for me, guys. Definitely thanks for watching. If you do enjoy these kind of videos, please rate, comment, subscribe. And I would say just ring the bell for notifications, but I think YouTube changed those. So if you do ring the bell, check and see, is this going to say all videos show occasionally or none? So obviously your discretion, but I would encourage you to ring the bell and choose all, so that way you can see every single video that I put out. Other than that, guys, definitely appreciate your you know, overall support and all the comments, the likes and everything. Definitely appreciate y'all. Even the naysayers, the ones that dislike my videos, the ones that post negative comments, whatever. I appreciate y'all too, because you make me want to do better. So that way I can kind of bring you in to the community and make, you know, eventually make you kind of warm up to the kind of quality I put out. But that's it, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.